Welcome back to my channel for another tutorial video. I will go over how to use loop statements, especially for for loop in GNU, Octave, and Matlab. Loop statements are very important computer languages for reading, writing, processing data by repeating sequence of commands for a given numbers of iteration and or conditions. In Octave and Matlab, there are two particular ways to create loop statements. The first one is for loop and the other is while loop. They give you the same functionality, but one provides an easier syntax than the other, depending on what you want to do. In this video, I will focus on for loop, and I will make another tutorial video for while loop in the near future. First of all, I will explain the basic syntax for the for loop. Then, I will go over a step-by-step script writing for the example project, which is calculating body mass index, BMI for short, from given height and body weight for 5 individuals. Finally, I will display the BMI categories such as underweight, normal weight, overweight, and obese for individual based on calculated BMI. I chose this project since this gives you an idea how to read, process, display the data using for loop. Here are the timestamps for each topic, and you can directly jump the topic that you want to learn. Without further ado, let's jump right in. Before you learn the loop statements, the most important question is why you need to learn the loop statement. Typically, the computer reads, calculates, displays one information at a time. If you have big list of data, you need to go through the data one by one, which is very time consuming. If you want to automatically go through the entire data, you may need to some computer language to handle these repeating instructions, which are loop statements. For example, if you have hundreds of students in your class to assign the letter grades based on the score for each, or millions of healthcare data for diagnostic work, the loop statements will be definitely helpful. Let's say you need to display my number is 1 through 5. You can manually display the such a series of text with the number change from 1 through 5. However, what if you need to much longer list, let's say a million lines? Perhaps you do not want to manually type such information, right? Question is how to use loop statement to finish such a job quickly. The basic idea of the for loop is to wrap the Octave and Matlab commands with the index having the row vector for iterations. The for loop needs to start with 4 followed by index, and we need to assign a row vector for index change and number of iterations. The for loop allows for automatic change of the index one by one from the first element to last element of the row vector, and the number of iteration will be the same as the length of row vector. The index should be a variable and it can be used as a part of Octave Matlab commands. Probably the simplest example would be to display the contents of a for loop index, since it will directly show how the for loop works. To display the contents of the for loop index, I will wrap the formatted display function called appprintf with the for loop. To remind you of how appprintf function works, I can write a simple script. I have a variable I equal to 1, and if I want to display the variable I in an integer format along with the sum text, you can type appprintf my index I equaled percentage d backslash n followed by I. I will save the script as my for loop under the working directory. In my computer, it will be c Mr. Stem Edu, but it can be different from your computer. Once you save and run the script, you will see my index I equal to 1 in the command window. Percentage d is a specifier within appprintf function, and this will replace by the contents of the variable I, and backslash n will be the enter after you display the contents of index I. Now I will use the variable I as a for loop index and display the content of the index I during the iterations. To build a for loop, I need to start with for, followed by the index I equals vector minus 2, 4, and 3 with a square bracket, and wrap up with end at the end. Normally, we do not use the index row vector like this, but for the demonstration purpose, we will specify the contents of the index I using square brackets. You can save and run again. And then you can see the three lines with the different contents of the index I. The basic idea here is that your index I changes from the first element to the last element as it iterates. And the numbers of iterations will be the same as the length of the row vector, which is 3. Now, let's practice how to use for loop to calculate BMI for multiple individuals. Before we talk about how to use for loop in BMI calculation, let's find out what the BMI is and how to use BMI for your health monitoring. The BMI stands for Body Mass Index, defined as body weight divided by the height squared. For example, one guy is 1.78 meter tall, having 68 kilogram weight. The BMI will be 68 divided by 1.78 squared, 21.5. From the BMI, you can categorize as underweight, normal weight, overweight, and obese based on the table. Since the BMI of this gentleman shows the BMI of 21.5, his BMI is under normal weight. Now, I think you understand the BMI better than before, then let's jump on the example problem to learn how to use for loop. Consider five individuals having height, weight, ID given in the table. I will create two variables, height and weight, for height and weight data as row vectors using the script editor in Octave and Matlab. To work with for loop, you can use ID as an index to access to height and weight data and calculate BMI for each individual as a row vector. For example, if you want to read the height and weight of the person ID 1, you can use a BMI formula as a BMI 1 equals weight 1 divided by height 1 squared. Basically, this expression provides the calculated BMI will be saved in the first element of the variable BMI. Since we need to iterate from ID 1 through 5, you can use ID as an index. To work with for loop, you can change this BMI formula to BMI I equals weight I divided by height I squared with the index I. For those of who need to understand how to use the index for variables, please watch my other video about this topic. Now, you will loop the BMI calculation through the index I using for loop from the row vector from 1 through 5. We can start with the BMI formula with the index I, and then you can wrap it up with 4, followed by the index I and row vector from 1 through 5. You can also display the ID, height, weight, and BMI as you iterate using fprintf function. We are using fraction numbers between percentage and specifier f, and these are the syntax to control the decimal points. I will make another tutorial video about this in the near future. Once you save and run the script, you can see the height, weight, and BMI over the three columns. Now you may want to display the BMI category under normal, overweight, and obese based on the BMI in the fourth column. First, we'll use the conditional statement to create a text for the BMI category depending on the BMI through the variable name category. Then, we can display the text given in the variable category using fprintf function. For the conditional statement, I will use if, else if, else statements. For those of you who do not know how to use the if, else statements, you can watch my other tutorial video. The conditional statement for the BMI category can be used right after the BMI calculation. If the BMI is below 18.5, the category text is underweight. I use the variable category followed by the underweight between the two single quotation marks. You can continue to finish the rest based on the BMI category table. Then you need to add the functionality to display the text by using the specifier percentage s for the string display, and you also need the category variable in the app printf. Once the script is saved and run, you can see what you designed for. In summary, this tutorial video went over the motivation of the loop statements. Then I showed how to use the for loop statements, followed by examples in the BMI calculation and BMI category display. Hope this tutorial video is useful to understand the for loop statement in reading, processing, displaying data in Octave and MATLAB. Thanks for watching this video, and please subscribe my channel if you want to continue to watch tutorial videos in science, technology, engineering, and math. Please give thumbs up if you enjoyed. Please feel free to share your thoughts in the comment section below, and see you next time.